Okay, this little video will be about how to sew button using thimbles. Well, first of all, why we need to sew button using thimbles? Only when we sew huge buttons, usually coat, leather coat, heavy jacket, and it's hard to push it with fingers only. Second of all, what kind of thimble to use? It's so many of them, different types, and well, different made. And this is a nice leather piece with some plastic in the middle, which is it's good to use, but I don't use to push this way, this direction towards the needle. I used to push this direction because I grew up with using metal thimbles. That's why it's not really useful for me. But sometimes just for embroidering, when I need to do something different, you know, like embroidering or knittings or something, I still have this little piece. Try to use it. All of them you can find online. Probably best place will be to find it or in the specialty stores. Now, this little rubber thimble. Is it good to use it? Yes, it's not bad. It's actually not bad, but again, not for a heavy job on this buttons, what I will show to you. Like leather, you sew buttons on a leather or on a heavy coat. It's again for some embroidering when you have so many stitching to go through, or just sew hooks, snaps, other buttons, and you do quite few of them. This will help you to push it through your needle, through that job, but not for heavy duty stuff. For heavy duty stuff, you always have to use metal thimbles. Let me show you the difference and explain to you which one is good, which one is don't, and why. This is it. That's what you have. You have one little one made in China. You have a little bit better one, which is made in China as well. And you have old-fashioned made in US thimble. Ceramic ones, I don't suggest to use. They're too slippery. Needle will slip right off them. No, well, it's just not usable. Why this one is the worst one? A little bit better, best one of all. Why? As you can see, this saddle where your needle will go, it's pretty small diameter. And edges of this saddle, it's totally smooth. It's mean needle will slip right through. Now, this little halfway holes you can see right here, it's really not that deep. They barely marked on that thimble. It's mean needle, it actually will not hold needle. If you push needle with this one, it will slide right through. Not gonna do job. No, well, make sure you're not getting this one. Here is a little bit better one. Why? Because saddle diameter of that is better. Second of all, better places for needles. It's not so slippery. It's more flat. Those edges is not as oval as the previous one. That's why it's a better one. And they all go on this finger, on middle finger. Doesn't matter what you choose, it's going right there. And this is the best one, which is hard to find stuff. It's made in US. And well, as you see difference? Do you see difference? It's a saddle is dipped down. It's have a little edge which is higher as rest of it. It's totally prevent needle to slip off. This is the best one to use. This needle will be pushed easy and never slip off, never hurt rest of your hand, because you use the right thimble. So how you do it? Well, it's really not that easy if you never used thimble before. But if you just start in sewing, I do suggest you'll use thimble on a regular base. In that case, it's easy to get used to it. Doesn't matter if you actually use it for push or not. Well, let's see. When you sew something like that, you will need on a heavy coat, you will need to make foot unless this button already have metal foot under or plastic foot under, which is none of this do. I pick up it on a purpose to show to you how to make that foot. Why you need that foot? Because it's gonna go on a heavy coat, leather coat, or just simply winter coat, heavy coat, and of course, whenever it's going on the top of this button hooked up over, it's have thickness that another side of your coat with loops, it's have thickness on its own, certain thickness, at least quarter inch or maybe more. And if buttons sew too flat, you will have trouble to button up. In this case, you will need at least quarter inch foot to make when you sew. As you go, you make that quarter inch foot under your button. Let me show how to do it. And another thing what you will need to know, what usually if you sew it on the leather, you will need also backing button to put on another side. Why? Because leather, it's stretchable, naturally stretchable. It's just a skin, animal skin. And when you button up, you know, sometimes those buttons got ripped out together with piece of leather. This backing button will prevent ripping through. Now, well, let's see how we can do it with foot and with backing button. Start as I showed to you in another video already, just like that. By the way, when you match backing button, make sure distance with your top button. See those holes? They spaced out about on the same distance as this front button for backing button. In that case, it will be easy to go in and out. So let's do it. Let's begin just from bottom. Just from bottom and position first. Just at least with that simple stitching like that. Just position it. Now, in order to have quarter inch foot, you will need to have some space between button and your work. Now, I'll use for it create that space another button or just scissors, anything to put it under. But that button will be not just laying flat like that. Not too close to it, just like that. Okay, and keep sewing. When you sew, that's how it goes. Your needle pushing that, your thimble pushing that needle right through. You got it. Go back. Again, see how it does? Your needle got pushed by your thimble. Well, this is just a little piece of fabric what I have for to make my sample on. But if you're pushing through leather, you really will need that push. You really will need your thimble because it will be so hard to push without. So that's how it goes. That's how you use it. You use it, your thimble, to push that needle. As soon as it's at least halfway through, you already can pull out. Make sure this is really not too close. After you make few stitchings, again, I do have very thick thread. I have a thread which is before I put in my needle loop, I double it. By the time what I put on needle loop and run through and make knot on a double layer, I come up with four layers of thread. That's what you do when you sew in heavy duty buttons. That's what I suggest to do when you sew any buttons. It will make your job much faster and much more productive. Now, when you got to the point when you did at least two, three stitchings in each hole, in each pair of holes, you come out in between, right here, in between fabric and your button, right there. This way, in between, sideways. Now you just simply wrap this thread just like that around your button several times. Create that foot tied up pretty good. Create that foot what we're looking for to make sure you can make it better even. That's why when you thread that, thread, make sure it's gonna be long one. What you need for all this job, for making foot, for making stitching, and put back in button on. Now, well, here you are. You have nice foot over there going on, as you can see, which is make that button stand up. You can see it's kind of spaced out, and will be easy to hook up on this kind of button, because it don't lay flat on material or on leather. It's staying out because of that foot. Now you can come out either way. Again, this way or other way. And that's going to be a time now to put backing button. Backing button don't have to be two stories sewing. Just like that. If you not, if you did not match for some reason your, I got some little thread here messed up. Don't worry about it. Just cover that there. And if you did not succeed to find your four holes the same size spaced out from each other like on your original button on the front, don't worry about it. You found different four holes, or you found two holes. That's a perfect scenario right here. But if you don't have a perfect scenario, you still can do it. Well, just for example, if you have only two holes, button, it doesn't matter. You just make sure it's holding up there. You're going through here, and you go to your original button. Sew all together. Your foot already there. That's why it will prevent you from tying to tie to the fabric or to the leather. Okay. And going through holes on your extra button on the backing. After you're done with that, just go sideways, right here, come out somewhere here. On the back, between fabric and your extra button. And make sure when you tied up, right in that together with the thread, in the fabric, needle with sideways, again, on leather, on a heavy coat, you push it with thimble. And do it at least three times. Make sure that button will stay. You got it. You got it. You got your backing button. You got your coat button. And the coat button have nice footer position on. As you can see, nice foot is not completely flat. It's mean another side of coat with a thick, because it's a coat, will be easy to button up. And it's very sturdy. It's not going anywhere. It's very sturdy. And If for some reason you put not enough thread or bad quality thread and it will break or you will catch on something, chances what this will be ripped out together with material is very slim, because that's what button for, backing button, what it will not rip with piece of material. This button will prevent of doing it. That's how it's done. And thank you for watching. Please check out this video. Have plenty of it already, and we'll come up at least with 3-4 every week. I really want to pass on you everything I know, what I learned from my grandparent, my grandpa, and from my own sewing experience. All these little tricks, how to do, what to do. Thank you. And don't forget to subscribe, and don't forget to push that little bell as well. Because your feed, in that case, you will be notified on new videos coming, when they coming, and also you will your feedback is welcome. Thank you.